田か、
吉
田。
あ、
チ
ャンスオーガナイザーズ、オーギビング、ギビングミーアプチュニティトゥトークアバットマイサーチ。And this talk is based on a collaboration with Katsuyuki Sugima at Kyoto University.Probably, almost audience are phenomenologists. I can organize three or four string theorists. So I briefly explain why we consider three-dimensional n equal to theory. Here, n equal to express the type of supersymmetry. In three dimensions, there are many non-trivial IR duality in three dimensions.Why is the cyborg-like duality? This is similar to the cyborg duality in four dimensions. But even cage group is U1, in three dimensions, theory flow to non-trivial IR fixed point. This is quite different from four dimensions. And if we include a Chan-Simon term, we can construct many wider class of the cyborg-like duality. This is called Hibbion-Pitasov.And there are other dualities, mirror symmetry and etc. Second motivation is the physics of M2 brain and M5 brain. A particular class of supersymmetric Chan-Simon matter theories is realized as a world volume theory of M2 brain. So to understand supersymmetric supersymmetric Chan-Simon matter theory,is important to understand the dynamics of M2 brain. And when we wrap M5 brain on direct product of three manifold, then another class of supersymmetric Chan-Simon matter theory appears. So it is also important to study these supersymmetric Chan-Simon matter. And the third motivation is ADS-CFT correspondence, an appropriate large N limit ofParticular class of supersymmetric Chan-Simon theory is dual to the 11-dimensional supergravity. The most famous and first discovered one is the so-called ABJ model. The gauge group is UN times UN and Chan-Simon coupling K and minus K, which couple to the four bifundamental chiral manifold. This is dual to the 11-dimensional supergravity on ADS4 times S7 over ZK.In general, it is difficult to check the duality, but recently localization techniques have been developed, and localization is efficient to check these dualities. For example, if theory and theory B float the same IR fixed point, a partition function of these two theories agree. And actually, by using the localization, we can check explicitly this statement. Or by using localization, we can extract the large N behavior of free energy of ABJ model. And free energy have this form. And this perfectly agrees with the real gravity action, on shell action. In the ADS-CFT dictionary, free energy should agree with the real gravity on shell action. Next, I explain what is the localization. We consider evaluating a partition function of a supersymmetric theory on compact manifold. Of course, supersymmetry exists or not, heavily depend on the shape of the manifold, but we simply assume supersymmetry. Supersymmetry means Killing Skinner exists on this manifold.And the partition function is expressed by the path integral as this. Here, phi express a correction of the field in supersymmetric theory. And L express a Lagrangian. We can deform the action by adding a one parameter family of Q exact term, TQB, this is TQB, without changing the value of partition.Here, one parameter means a real parameter T, and Q exact term means a term expressed as some supersymmetric transformation of some local operator. Q is the one of the supercharge. And the statement of the localization is following. In the T infinity limit, WKB approximation around the zero locus of QB is exact. And a partition function is expressed as a path integral over zero locus of QB, and the integrand consists of a saddle point value of original Lagrangian and one loop determinant of QB. Here delta over delta phi express a functional delta. So the infinite dimensional path integral reduces the finite dimensional integral, and a great simplification occurs. In three dimensions, there are two important manifolds on which localization computation are performed. One is a, roughly speaking, a three-dimensional sphere, a Schwarzschild sphere, equation is defined as this, 10b equal to 1, this is ordinary term sphere. And the second manifold is S1 times S2, a partition function on this geometry is known as a superconformal. Which count of particular BPS operators. Definition is this one, and D express a transnational charge along S1 direction, and JSE express a spin, and F express a global charge, and MK and beta 2 and beta 1 express a fugacity for these charges, and L, R express a R charge, and F, F, F express the fermion. For example, three-dimensional n equal to theory, gauge group is U1, and NF flavor, a charge plus one chiral match bed with real mass. After using a localization, a partition function on ellipsoid expressed as this one. And partition function on S1 times S2 expressed as this. Integrand is some complicated function. But when we perform this remained one-dimensional integral, these two partition functions on ellipsoid and S1 factorize the same function we are. The difference between the ellipsoid and S1 times is the argument of this function. Ellipsoid case, Q is related to the Schwarzschild parameter, and X is related to the mass. And superconformal index case, Q is related to the fugacity, and X is related to the fugacity for global charge. So, and Wim-Dimorte Pasquet conjecture that this factorization structure is universal for a three-dimensional n equal to Chan-Simon-Mata theories. And this beta alpha is regarded as a fundamental building of block of three-dimensional partition. They named this B alpha as a holomorphic block. And they also gave a construction rule of this holomorphic block. Holomorphic block itself is expressed as a multi-contour integral, and the integrand consists of vector multiplet contribution and Chan-Simon contribution and chiral multiplet contribution. I cannot explain the technical detail of derivation of this holomorphic block because this paper is almost 120 pages, and about 15 pages are devoted to derive this rule, not a 15 page. And there are a construction, but roughly speaking, use the analogy of topological and anti-topological fusion in two dimensions. From this analogy, this B alpha, we expect this B alpha is a partition, realized as a partition function on S1 times hemisphere. This S1 times hemisphere has the same topology as the solid topology. We briefly explain the analogy of the topological and the anti-topological fusion. Next slide. Chekhov said that two-dimensional two-comma two theory on S1, on S2, that partition function can be constructed by swelling to hemisphere partition function. So partition function S2 also factorized to two-hemisphere partition function, and naively three-dimensional n equal to partition function on these geometry can be regarded as a two-dimensional two comma two theory on S2. This S2 is a base, this S2 or base space of this ellipsoid with infinitely many KK mode, KK mode associated to the, this pi by S1 direction. So naively, this partition function also factorized to a partition function on S1 times hemisphere. So my question is it possible to realize this holomorphic block as a partition function on S1 times hemisphere and derive it directly by localization? This is my motivation. In order to use a localization, perform a localization, first we construct three-dimensional supersymmetric theory on this geometry. This geometry is a curve, so construction of supersymmetry is not so simple, but by embedding S1 times hemisphere into S1 times S2, we can construct the supersymmetry and Lagrangian of this theory. Coordinate region of the S1 times S2 is we use a polar coordinate. Theta is along this direction, and phi is along this direction. And coordinate along S1 direction is we use a tau. And R is the radius of this hemisphere or S2. And circumference of this S1 is we use beta times R. Boundary of hemisphere is specified by pi over 2. And first we review the S1 supersymmetric theory on S1 times S2. And after we introduce a boundary and impose a boundary condition which preserves the supersymmetry. N equal 2 theory on this geometry consists of two multiplet. One is a vector multiplet. Vector multiplet consists of three-dimensional gauge field and real auxiliary field. Real field B and real scalar and Dirac field. And action consists of the two parts. One is the supersymmetric Chan-Simon term. Kappa expresses the Chan-Simon coupling. This is of course a supersymmetric invariant, but not written as a QM zone. On the other hand, supersymmetric Yamil's action is written as a QM exact. So in the localization computation, we can use a supersymmetric Yamil's action as a QM exact term. The other multiplet is a so-called chiral multiplet. This consists of complex scalar and Dirac fermion and complex auxiliary field. And the kinematic action of the chiral multiplet is also written as a QM exact. So we can use this Lagrangian as a Q-exact term in the localization computation. And there are another Lagrangian which is called superpotential. This is not a Q-exact, but in the localization computation, this part does not appear, so we simply omit this. Next, we have to impose a particular boundary condition because in order to use the localization, a supersymmetric have to be preserved. And we find that a boundary a condition which preserves the half of supersymmetry at the boundary. For the vector multiplet, a boundary condition is expressed as this, and the ellipse expresses a boundary condition for D and lambda, which respects the supersymmetry. And for the chiral multiplet, there are two possible boundary conditions. One is the Neumann boundary condition, second is the Dirichlet type boundary condition. And the ellipse also express a boundary condition for psi and f. And in with this boundary condition, it restricts of the three-dimensional supersymmetric transformation for the boundary torus. In this case, boundary of S1 times hemisphere is torus into the so-called two-dimensional 0,2 supersymmetric transformation. And more precisely, three-dimensional M equal to vector multiplet leads to the supersymmetric transformation of the 0,2 vector multiplet. And then we choose the Neumann boundary condition, supersymmetric transformation of the chiral multiplet leads to the boundary 0,2 chiral multiplet. And then we choose the Dirichlet type boundary condition, there is a Kelvin multiplet. And we can also introduce additional 0,2 multiplet at the boundary, which couples the three-dimensional field. With this boundary condition, Super-Yamil's action and kinematic action of the chiral multiplet are invariant under supersymmetric transformation, and again, it was QM. On the other hand, Chan-Simon term is problematic because under the supersymmetric transformation, this term is not invariant and have this surface term. But we can introduce, we construct the following boundary interaction which compensates the supersymmetric transformation of the bulk Chan-Simon. So supersymmetry is preserved, but still this Chan-Simon term and bounded Chan-Simon term is problematic because this is not gauge invariant. Not gauge invariant, so the theory is not well defined. How to theory make theory gauge invariant? Answer is use the anomaly, so-called anomaly flow. We introduce a boundary 0,2 multiplet whose gauge anomaly cancels this term, Chan-Simon gauge non-invariant. Recall that the gauge anomaly of 0,2 chiral and Fermi multiplet have this form. Here QM express the gauge charge for chiral multiplet and Q dash express the gauge charge for Fermi multiplet. So this coefficient, this coefficient equal this kappa, then the theory is fully gauge invariant and Suji invariant. So we construct a supersymmetric theory on S1 times F. Hemisphere, next we perform the localization. But I don't have enough time, so briefly present the result. This is a localization computation, and in this case, saddle point is a constant configuration for the gauge field along S1 direction. And the saddle point value of the Q-Claw term comes from the boundary Chan-Simon term, which contains the A squared, A is this saddle point constant configuration of the gauge. And one loop determinant expressed as this. And important point is that a prefactor contains again a quote A squared term. And partition function on S1 times hemisphere have to be invariant, and the sieve, this is the saddle point configuration of the gauge field along S1 direction, because this sieve corresponds to the large gauge transformation. But apparently, a quadratic term in the saddle point of the Chan-Simon term and E is not invariant under this sieve. But previous condition, which is anomaly cancellation condition, is satisfied. These non-invariant terms are cancelled, so the partition function is invariant under this. Similar phenomena occur in the computation of the four-dimensional N4-1 superconformal index. In this case, cubic term appears, but this non-invariant term vanishes when all the anomaly cancellation condition are satisfied here. Anomaly means a four-dimensional anomaly, gauge anomaly, and gauge and gravitational mix anomaly, and asymmetry gauge mix anomaly. So in four dimension, similar mechanism. And then we introduce a boundary multiplet to satisfy the anomaly cancellation condition. one loop determinant of the boundary multiplet produce the chance-time contribution in the holomorphic block. And the contribution of the chiral multiplet in the holomorphic block is same as the one loop determinant of the three-dimensional chiral multiplet with Dirichlet type boundary. So we can reproduce a holomorphic block for the chance-time matter theory by using a localization. We briefly summarize. We have construct the three-dimensional n equal to supersymmetric chance-time matter theory on S1 times hemisphere with a specified half BPS boundary function. And the type of the supersymmetry preserved on the boundary torus is at n equals 0 comma 2 times. And we also evaluate this partition function by using a localization and check the holomorphic.
Yeah, so if there's no any questions, so there's a second speaker again.